Okay, so this is number two on practice three. This is the one that we worked on in class, but here's the solution in case you need it. So it says a 5 kilogram ball is dropped from a height of 3 meters onto a vertical spring, which has a spring constant of 800 newtons per meter. How much will the spring compress? All right, and we have to also assume that it's gonna compress into the ground and the ball's gonna come to a stop, okay, which wasn't super clear. So let's make a little sketch of it. I don't know where I'm gonna draw it because I don't really have very much space here, but so you're gonna have like the, whoops, where's my pen at? On the eraser. Okay, so you're gonna have like the ground and there's a ball and there's a spring, okay? And then afterwards, the spring's all compressed down and the ball is sitting on top of it. All right, so this is position A and B. So let's see what we're given. A 5 kilogram ball, a height of 3 meters, okay? And it also says there's 10 joules of energy dissipated by air resistance in the fall, okay? So for position A, we're gonna go through and we're gonna ask ourselves the questions. So is it above the ground? Yes, so it has EG. Is it moving? No, because it says it's dropped. Okay, so it's not thrown, it's dropped, which means it starts from rest. Is there a spring and is it stretched or compressed? So yes, there's a spring, but it's not stretched or compressed yet. And is there any friction or air resistance? Yes, but never in position A because nothing's happened yet, all right? So that leaves us knowing that the whole entire first bar for position A is all EG, so my entire pie chart is EG, okay? All right, so I know there's no kinetic, no elastic, and no dissipated. So that only leaves me with EG, okay? So we're gonna have EG equals MGH, okay? I'm looking for the EG. I know the mass is 75 kilograms. G is 10 newtons per kilogram. And the height is 3 meters. Oops, it's not 75, sorry, that was the other problem. 5 kilograms, okay? So 5 times 10 times 3 gives me 150 joules, all right? So since I know there's no other energies, when I add all of these up, I see that my total is gonna have to be 150 joules, all right? Okay, so then this is gonna be 150 also. Okay, so the big thing about energy is the total energy is conserved every time. It stays the same all the time. So if it's 150 here, every other position has to be also 150. Okay, there's no other choice. It always is the same. All right, so let's look at position B, what's happening now when the ball's on the ground. Okay, so EG, is it above the ground? No, we're assuming it stops at the ground level, right? That wasn't clear in the problem. I had to kind of adjust it after. Is it moving? No, also not super clear in the problem, but implied that the ball comes to a stop, okay? Spring stretched or compressed? Yes. And is there dissipated energy? Yes, because it says 10 joules are dissipated in the fall. So I know this is gonna be 10 joules here, okay? I know it's not moving, and I know it's not above the ground, all right? Okay, so I have some amount of only 10 joules of ED, but my total is 150. That means there has to be 140 joules here for elastic energy because this has to total up to 150, all right? So my ED is super tiny, okay? And so then my EE is gonna be all the rest of it, okay? And again, I'm using the fill up method, right? Because I like to make it all look to the top. So there's a tiny little piece of ED, the rest of it is EE, okay? So it asks us how much does the spring compress, so I know that that's X. So I need to use my formula for elastic energy. Okay, it's gonna be 140 here. I'm not gonna write the units, mainly because it's hard to write with this tablet, but if you can write the units, you should, but if it's throwing you off, you can just write them at the end, okay? Not my favorite, but what are we gonna do? Okay, so 140 equals 1/2 times 800. So that's gonna be 140 equals 400x squared. I just multiplied the 1/2 times 800. Okay, and then I can divide both sides by 400, which leaves me with x squared equals whatever 140 over 400 is. Let's see. Calculator. 140 divided by 400 is 0.35. Oops, why is this so weird? Okay, 0.35. And I don't want x squared, I just want x. So that means I have to take the square root of both sides, which leaves me with x equals 0.59 meters. Okay, so that's how far that the spring is compressed, and I know it's in meters because it's a distance. Okay, so my pi then is gonna look like a little tiny sliver of ED. The rest of the pi is EE. Okay, all right, so that is number 2.